فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. This is our second lesson inshallah ta'ala. Last lesson we spoke about what does it mean to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And inshallah ta'ala we mentioned believing in Allah, it stands on singling Allah in Tawheed al-Rububiyyah and Tawheed al-Uluhiyyah and Tawheed al-Asma' wa-Sifat. So inshallah ta'ala today we're going to go into what does it mean Tawheed al-Rububiyyah in more details. And we're going to explain it more and understand it better inshallah ta'ala. Here on the board I have Rububiyyah. تَقُومُ عَلَى رُبُوبِيَّةِ stands on وُجُودُ اللَّهِ. So, تُحِيدُ الرُّبُوبِيَّةِ and رُبُوبِيَّةِ that we were speaking about, which is to single Allah in رُبُوبِيَّةِ, it stands on two things. It stands on believing وُجُودُ اللَّهِ, Allah's existence, subhanahu wa ta'ala. That Allah tabarak wa ta'ala exists. And the second one is إِفْرَادُ اللَّهِ بِأَفْعَالِهِ, to single Allah in His actions that He does, subhanahu wa ta'ala. When a person comes with those two, they have surely come with what? التوحيد الربوبية. So توحيد الربوبية, my brothers and sisters, it means, or it stands on, meaning if you don't have these two, then your توحيد الربوبية does not exist. It stands on believing Allah tabarak wa ta'ala exists. And there are groups of people who believe Allah doesn't exist, subhanahu wa ta'ala. They're called malahida, atheists, agnostics, who don't believe in Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's existence. The truth of the matter of those people is their rejection or their disbelief in Allah's existence is from the out. It's from the outer. It's from that which seems apparent to us. But from within, they believe in Allah's existence. It is mustahil, it's impossible that somebody does. Because Allah tabarak wa ta'ala says to us in the Quran about Fir'aun, who falls into this category. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what did He say about Fir'aun? He said, وَجَحَدُوا بِهَا وَاسْتَيْقَنَتْهَا أَنفُسُهُمْ ظُلْمًا وَعُلُوًا. From the outer was his rejection. Because Allah says, وَجَحَدُوا بِهَا, he showed rejection to it. He showed hard-headedness towards it. But Allah then says, وَاسْتَيْقَنَتْهَا أَنفُسُهُمْ. But his nafs, his soul, it believed in it. Fir'aun believed Allah exists. Fir'aun deep down believed that Allah was single subhanahu wa ta'ala in his actions. He believed that. But what he did was, he showed to the people. Because that's why Allah says, ظُلْمًا وَعُلُوًا. He was doing it out of oppression, and he was doing it out of wanting to be high. لِذَلِكَ, that's why Nabiullah Musa, when he came to Fir'aun, he said to Fir'aun, لَقَدْ عَلِمْتَ مَا أَنزَلَ هَؤُلَاء إِلَّا رَبُّ السَّمَاوَاتِ. Fir'aun, you know. You do know. That no one else sent this down on me except Allah. You know that. And Fir'aun did know. Ayat in the Quran show. Because look what he said to his minister, Haman. He said, Ya Haman, ibn li sarha. Haman, build for me a ladder. And what does he want to do with the ladder? He said, Attali'u ila ilahi Musa. So I can see the Lord of Nabiullah Musa. But if he didn't believe in it, he wouldn't have said that. The reason is because my brothers and sisters who are watching, the atheists and the agnostics, when hardship and pain touches them, they know to remember Allah. Just look at an atheist today, when something falls onto him or something happens to him, he automatically says, oh God. Because their fitrah, the basic instinct, believes in Allah's existence. رَوَى الْبُخَارِيُّ وَمُسْلِمْ فِي صَحِيحَيْهِمَا. Bukhari and Muslim both narrated in their sahih That the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, مَا مِن مَوْلُودٍ إِلَّا وَهُوَ يُولَدُ عَلَى الْفِطْرَةِ فَأَبَوَاهُ يُهَوِّدَانِهِ أَوْ يُنَصِّرَانِهِ أَوْ يُمَجِّسَانِهِ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, that there is no newborn baby except that he is born upon Islam. So the fitrah, the basic natural instinct of every single human being is Allah tabarak wa ta'ala and Islam. So everyone's born as a Muslim. But then what happens after is their parents play a role in their life and they deviate them from that basic instinct. They either make them Christians or they make them Jews, or they even try to push them to becoming atheists or agnostics. But the basic instinct doesn't fully remove. It doesn't remove from what? From believing wujudullahi, Allah's existence. It doesn't remove from that. And it also doesn't remove from believing in Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala's actions and that which he has done, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and singling him in those actions. The fitrah knows that. And that is why when you see people who are agnostics or atheists, at times of hardship, they run to something. Even those who push this theory in saying that, those who push the theory of saying Big Bang, this is what caused it all, they can't leave except to explain that something did this. So they worship either aliens or they worship the Big Bang. They worship something. There is nothing except they do worship. Because the fitrah tells us this and the fitrah pushes us towards this. The second one is ifradullahi bi af'alihi, singling Allah in his actions. You single Allah in creation. He's the one who created you. You don't give that characteristics to anyone other than Allah. Sustenance, how your affairs is controlled and it's looked after, is done by Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. He's the one who nurtures you. He's the one who raised you. He's the one who cultivates you. He is the one who purifies you. He is the one who runs your affairs. He's the one who takes your life. He's the one who gives you life again. He's the one who resurrects you. These are actions which he does, subhanahu wa ta'ala. You single him in these actions. You do not associate anybody with him in it. Allahu khaliqu kulli shay. Allah is the one who created everything. Allah is the one who created everything, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is where Allah said in the Quran, in the first ayah of the opening verse in the Quran, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. He is the Lord, Rabb Rububiyah, the Lord of the universe. He runs the universe. He created the universe. He provides for what's in the universe and itself. Everything in it, he has knowledge of it, subhanahu wa ta'ala. We single those things for him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Keeping in mind, my brothers and sisters, having Tawheedul Rububiyah does not make you a Muslim. Having Tawheedul Rububiyah alone does not make you a Muslim. Because Tawheedul Rububiyah was found with the pagans and the polytheists. Rather, as I said to you, it was found with Fir'aun. And it was found with Iblis, who said to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, خَلَقْتَنِي مِن نَارٍ وَخَلَقْتَهُ مِن طِينٍ. خَلَقْتَنِي مِن نَارٍ. You created me from fire, which is an action of Allah. He's affirming it for him. You are the one who created me. You are the one who I want to allow me to live. What did he say? Rabbi, Rabbi. He called him by Rabb. Rabbi, fa'anzirni ila yawmi yub'athun. Oh Allah, wait for me. Wait for me until the day of judgment. So Fir'aun, Iblis, Kuffar of Quraysh, all of them, they affirmed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's actions and they singled him in it. Iblis did not turn around and did not look at Adam or the angels and say to them, give me a long life so I can destroy and I can misguide the creation. He didn't say that, but he looked at Allah and he called on to Allah. This is who? This is Iblis. So believing or having Tawheedul Rububiyyah alone does not bring you into the fold of Al-Islam. This is very important that one understands this and that they digest that information. But what is needed from you is the ones that we're going to be speaking about, which is the third one, Tawheedul Uluhiyyah. Now the question arises, if Tawheedul Rububiyyah, it stands on believing in Allah's existence and also singling Allah in his actions, then what are the things that nullify your Tawheed al-Rububiyyah? And as you're all aware of, an opposite allows you to really understand the other side. وَبِهِ تَتَمَيَّزُ الْأَشْيَاءِ. Sometimes you may not know a word. Okay? For instance, you didn't know what the word male meant. And I said to you, it is the opposite of female. But you knew what female meant, but you didn't know what male meant, for example. And I had come to you and said to you, you don't know what male means? You say no. It is the opposite of female. And you already know female. Just by me telling you the opposite, you know, you recognize what male is. So that is why it's important to always try to learn things from this opposite side as well. So it can become more clear to you both sides and what they are. Nawaqidu Tawheed al-Rububiyyah. The nullifying of Tawheed al-Rububiyyah. What can cause the Tawheed al-Rububiyyah to nullify? When can we say that this person does not have Tawheed al-Rububiyyah? When these three are there, your Tawheed al-Rububiyyah has nullified. The first one is Inkaru wujudillahi fi al-Zahir. It is to reject the existence of Allah from the outer. And the reason why we say from the outer, because from the inner, you can't reject Allah's existence. Iblis could not. Fir'aun didn't. Internally, he believed in Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's existence. All of this is from the what? From the outer. And inshallah ta'ala, if we do ever study more in details regarding the issues of how many forms of kufr are there, or how many types of ways can a person become a kafir, this type of kufr is called kufr al-juhud. Kufr al-juhud, which means you believe it internally, but you disbelieve it externally. It's the opposite to the disbelief of hypocrisy. The disbelief of hypocrisy is what? You show that you believe from the outer, but you disbelieve from the inner. Kufr al-juhud is what? Kufr al-juhud means you believe from within, but you disbelieve from the outer. And this is what happens. These people have come with kufr al-juhud. Their rejection of Allah's existence is only from the outer. It can't be from the inner, because as I said, the inner, the fitrah stands, and the fitrah doesn't allow it. So it's to reject Allah from the outer. As you see all these atheists and these agnostics, as they do. إِثْبَاتُ فَاعِلْ مُسْتَقِلٌ مَعَ اللَّهِ. The second one is to affirm that there is a doer who does independent from Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, who does things like Allah. So there's two creators that create us. As you would find from the fire worshippers, they believe there is a God of evil and a God of good. You see? But this belief of إِثْبَاتُ فَاعِلٍ مُسْتَقِلٍ مَعَ اللَّهِ, even within those who claim it, they can't tend to really bring two gods that are both of them 100% doing the same, because it contradicts one another. It's impossible that there are two gods and they're 100% they're both doing it. One is stronger than the other. There's one stronger than the other. But ala kulli hal, if a person affirms a doer that does things with Allah in such as those which Allah is alone in, like al-khalq wal-mulk wal-tadbir, then that individual has fallen into that which nullifies Tawheed al-Rububiyyah. The third one is إِضَافَةُ النِّعْمَةِ لِغَيْرِ اللَّهِ اسْتِقْلَالًا. It is attributing a blessing to other than Allah independently. You actually believe that this, for example, me wearing this thobe, it was independently a gift that was given to me by a person. Independently, Allah had nothing to do with it. This person is why independently. We're not saying if the person says that this person has blessed me with this, but Allah tabarak wa ta'ala allowed him to do it, then that means you are affirming for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the blessing. And this person is, you're doing it min babi taba'a, they're following the blessing on the side. Lakin istiqlalan, to independently believe that this person, if it wasn't for them, you would never got it. This now becomes kufrun, a disbelief. In what? Lakin, This kufr is kufrun in Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's rububiyyah. It is kufr in the rububiyyah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now my brothers and sisters, I hope I have given you a good understanding of what it means of Tawheed al-Rububiyyah. One more time, inshaAllah ta'ala, let me go over it. Tawheed al-Rububiyyah, it stands on two things, or two pillars. Believing in Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's existence. The second one is Ifradullah bi af'alihi, singling Allah tabarak wa ta'ala in his actions that he comes with subhanahu wa ta'ala. Kal khalqi wal mulki wal tadbiri. Such as creating and sustenance and kingdom is all for him alone. Nawaqidu tawheed al-rububiyyah, the things that nullify the tawheed al-rububiyyah. We said it's three things. Rejecting the existence of Allah outwardly. The second one is ithbatu fa'il mustaqillun ma'a Allah, affirming that there is a doer independent with Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. I mean, they're doing it with him. They're doing things with him, but they're independent from him. Or idafatu ni'mah, attributing a blessing لغير الله, to other than Allah, استقلالا, independently. You are actually attributing this blessing to other than Allah, استقلالا, independently. When we know that everything exalts Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. تسبح له السماوات والأرض. The samawat and the earth and everything that are in it. وَإِن مِّن شَيْءٍ يُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِي وَلَكِنْ لَا تَفْقَهُونَ تَصْبِيحَهُمْ. Everything exalts Allah. Everything. وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَظَلُومٌ كَفَّارٌ. That every blessing that we have is from Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Attributing it to other than Allah, independently, it is kufrun. But this kufr, it hits tawheed al-rububiyyah. I will stop there inshaAllah ta'ala for today's lesson. Anything which I have said that was incorrect is from me and shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. I hope you have understood it very well. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.